Today at World Talk, we will be joined by David Patrikarakos. He is the author of War in 140 Characters and will be discussing the 21st century wars, how propaganda supports military warfare, and the spread of disinformation in today's era.
In the book, where I spent a year, and it's important to understand that Ukraine was the laboratory for all the techniques that you've subsequently seen Russia use in terms of disinformation. So I talk about 21st century wars. Now, obviously, Iraq and Afghanistan were fought in the 21st century, but they were fundamentally 20th century wars. Ukraine was the first, what I call 21st century war. And that is a war designed essentially not as in classic warfare to deliver a military victory, but military means used to deliver a propaganda victory. And that is the difference, because, you know, propaganda is as old as war itself. But traditionally, propaganda has supported military operations on the ground. Now, what we saw in Ukraine was military operations on the ground designed to support propaganda.
So it's almost inversed.
Absolutely. They've inverted the traditional paradigm of war. So in terms of disinformation, what Putin did is he sent in Russian troops and soldiers into Ukraine to clear out a space to allow narrative to be pumped in.
Well, this is the question, right? And this is what a lot of these hearings and the analysis of these hearings, that it's, in fact, is it the end of democracy?
You know, what it does do is it levels the playing field in terms of allowing voices that can come together that would not have been heard to be heard. And what it does, fundamentally, social media is anti-state. It is not built around the architecture of states. It is by its nature transnational. It doesn't care about borders. It doesn't care about institutions. Look, when we talk about, you know, the sort of the interference in American election, people think that it's all about, ads supporting Trump. No, a lot of them were actually designed to stop people voting at all, to spread so much negative propaganda that people went, you know what? A plague on both their houses. I'm not voting for anyone. And this is the thing. It is designed to spread so many lies around that you can't recognize the truth when you see it. And this is the one similarity between Putin and Trump. Now, look, you know, I don't like Trump. It's easy to criticize Trump, but let's step back. He's still the leader of the world's largest democracy. Putin is a dictator in all that name. But in one sense, they are the same. And that is this.
All right, let's talk about alternative facts.
Sure, let's do it.
Fake news.
Yes.
It's thrown around everywhere. Yeah. People want to believe what they want to believe.
Sure. Look, this was always the case. If I'm from Britain, if you're slightly to the left, you'll read The Guardian. If you're slightly to the right, you'll read The Telegraph. You know, people fundamentally want their prejudices reaffirmed or their own pre-existing beliefs reaffirmed.
But not necessarily with alternative facts.
No, this is my point. There were limits, right? Look, I'll give you an example. Let's take, for the sake of argument, an Arab-Israeli war, okay? 20 years ago, if Israel and Hamas or Israel and an Arab nation went to war, you would have pro-Israelis, pro-Arabs, pro-Palestinians. Fine. But here's the thing, they would both watch, unless they are on the ground, and most people weren't on the ground, they would both watch the same thing coming out of BBC, CNN, whatever, you know. And this content was like the content here, produced by professional editors, professional journalists, professional videos. They'd both watch the same stuff. Now, they would draw their own conclusions from it, but at least they would have some common ground. Now, what happens is you can pick, you know, your own sources of video footage on social media, depending on who you follow, your own articles, depending on who you want to read, on who you follow, and you create your own information bubble. Look, if I want to make you now say, I hate black people, I would have to edit, right? And cut you saying black, hate. Now, with the technology that's coming in, I can manipulate your face that you will say, and no one can tell the difference now.
So what, anarchy?
I'm not saying that. I'm saying that things are going to get worse. Well, we've already had major events. Ukraine was a major event. The US election was a major event. I foresee several more of these, but getting slowly worse as the technology increases.